Hello and welcome. I'd like to show you what you can do with my Game Boy Advance to MIDI cable. As you can see, I've got a Game Boy Advance and a MIDI keyboard here with my cable in between. The Game Boy Advance is capable of making noises on six different MIDI channels and all have their unique properties. I'd like to show them all to you, so let's start off with keyboard channel 1. Keyboard channel 1 is a square wave producing channel with an envelope applied to it. So, as you can hear, it makes fairly standard Game Boy-ish bleeps. Like all the other MIDI channels, it's touch sensitive, so if you press your key harder, it'll make a louder noise. You can hear, and you can also do stuff like pitch bend. And if you connect a LFO to the pitch, you can also do a vibrato like thing. Channel 1 also supports setting the duty cycle, but I'll let you hear how that sounds later. So, on to channel 2. And channel 2 is connected to the original Game Boy hardware that lets you load 4-bit samples into it and then place those at a certain frequency. So, let's see, this is the correct one. Yes, first of all, there's the standard square one. You should recognize it by now. But you can also make other noises like a triangle wave, or a saw wave, or some other random samples. You can hear. Like the first channel, this channel also supports arpeggio, which means you can press multiple keyboard keys at once and it will go and alternate between those notes. As you can hear. So, on to keyboard channel 3. And keyboard channel 3 is basically the same as keyboard channel 1, but it has a sweep function, which means that you can the Game Boy hardware will increment or decrement the frequency the note plays at. And that sounds a bit like this. That's up, and that's down. You can adjust the frequency, the speed it does it. And as you hear, the channel also has an envelope function. Okay, on to channel 4. And channel 4 is a bit special, but because it doesn't correspond to any classic Game Boy channel. It's a software synthesizer which makes use of the Game Boy Advance hardware and the 32-bit microcontroller that's in there. It can produce up to 8 notes simultaneously. So it sounds a bit like this. It's a bit like an organ. You can actually modify the waveform a bit. You just heard a square wave, this is a sine. And this is a saw wave. Okay, you can also do the standard stuff like pitch bend. Vibrato, etc. So, onto the last channel, which is channel 10. And channel 10 has the percussions, so you can make stuff like drum loops. And that's basically it. It's a noise generator, and you can modify the frequency the noise is generated at by pressing a note. Okay, there's one more feature, and that's the sequencer this thingy has. You can record up to 8 different tracks and then play them all at once. So, for example, let's record the little drum, sorry, the little percussion loop I just made. And you can then play it back again. Okay, as you can hear, my rhythm feeling isn't that great. I'm going to do it just once more. Let's hope it works this time. Good enough. Okay, so I would really like to play a great musical song here for you live, but as you just heard, my rhythm and instrument feeling basically sucks. I really have to learn it. But what I can do is enter a few nice melodies into the sequencer and then play them all at once, which is basically what I did. And I will enable all the channels one by one, so you can hear where I'm going to, well, basically enjoy. Interpretation of Martin Galway's comic kitchen music. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.